place at the Harris House on April 29, 1984. I am speaking to Mr. Harold Skinner. I am just in loss. Thank you, Mr. Skinner, for taking part in our World War II local history project. Can you give your name, rank, and serial number?
This is Harold Skinner. My rank upon discharge was captain in the aircraft. My serial number is 06319544.
Were you a student or were you through school when the war broke out?
I was a student at Middlebury College and I enlisted at the end of my second year as a sophomore.
Where were you living?
My hometown, I was living in Fultonville, New York.
What year did you enter the service? What branch of the service were you in?
I entered the service in December of 1943 in the Air Corps.
And what branch of the service were you in?
Air Force.
Did you enlist or were you drafted?
I enlisted.
Where did you receive your basic training?
In Texas. The primary training as a fire was in Body Sham. Basic training was in Greenville. And advanced training was in Amarillo, Texas.
When did you go overseas?
42. October of 1943.
In what theater of war did you serve?
The 8th Air Force.
Where were you stationed?
I was stationed in the 8th Air Force at Body Sham, Suffolk, England. We flew out of Body Sham.
What were your duties in the military?
I was a fighter pilot. We flew P-51s and we escorted bombers whenever they went on bombing missions, and then when we finished with the escort, we used to drop down in strafe airfields or anything that moved in Europe or in Germany or any place over in Europe.
How many fighter missions did you go on, and can you tell us about a fighter mission?
A fighter mission usually lasted anywhere from 4 to 6 hours, and I flew 72 fighter missions.
Were you ever wounded, and when were you awarded the
BSC.
Yeah.
Distinguished flying prize. Repeat that question, please.
Were you ever wounded?
I was never wounded, but one time when we strafed in an airfield in Germany, I was hit with flak. And when I came back from, I was able to fly the plane back then, and I had to belly it in, did the landing gear and come down. So that was my closest experience being wounded.
When were you awarded the...
I can't remember exactly, Jesse. Sometime in 44. Sometime in spring of 44.
Where were you when the war ended?
I was in England. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry, I came back from England and we were teaching aerial gunnery down in Lake Pontchartrain down in Louisiana. And the war ended and I was home about a month later.
Have you ever returned to where you were during the war, and would you like to, or why or why not?
No, I've never returned there, but I don't think I had that much attachment to it. It was just a place that we flew our missions out of, so I don't think I ever was that interested in going back just to see that place.
How do you think serving in the military during the war affected your life?
Well, it taught me to appreciate the freedom of choice and doing what you wanted to do. When I came back, I went back into the college and graduated and became a teacher. And that's what I've always been interested in. So just being in the war, of course, assisted me with financial matters when I got back because the expenses of education was taken over by the U.S. government.
When did you come to the Otego area and what brought you here?
I came to Otego in 1954, and I became principal of Otego Central School. And then Otego Central School and Unitego combined and became Unitego, and I became superintendent of Unitego Central School in 1972, and retired from that position in 1979. And I've stayed here ever since because this has more or less become my home.
Why do you think it is important to preserve the stories of those who lived during the World War II years?
Hopefully by telling them the stories of what happened and things that occurred that it might prevent future wars, the people that would communicate with others, each other better than they did back in those days.
Note that you were involved in the D-Day Normandy invasion.
Yes, indeed.
Can you give us some information about the preparations that led up to the day and anything else you remember about it?
Well, the preparations, as far as we were concerned, I was with the 374th Fighter Squadron. We were flying just plain missions, escorting bombers to various parts of Europe, Germany, and so forth, no change in our routine. But on D-Day, when the invasion took place, we flew three missions that day down southwest of Paris. And all we did was fly on the deck down on the ground and strafe anything that moved that could have been German movement, troops and tanks or anything that moved in down strafes. And we flew three missions that day. We got up at 5 o'clock in the morning, got home at 10 o'clock at night.
Are there any other memories or thoughts you'd like to share?
All I can say, Jesse, is that being in the Air Force and meeting with various fellows from all over the United States, you got a pretty good idea of cross-section of what people did, what they came from, the type of people that made up our population, you know. I had some good friends. I no longer stay in communication with them. It's been a long time, but I do have pictures and so forth of them, which maybe, I don't know if you want to show them on this interview, but I mean, I have those available.
Okay. Thank you very much for this interview.
Well, that didn't take very long, did it?